let's move to our next part. And I just want to start with a little note. If you about how we start learning a new piece. So if you start learning a new piece without any idea about which movements would be the most efficient in the piece and just kind of sight reading it, trying to make everything right away, dynamics, articulations, expression, I mean, you know how it goes, then some weeks later you will always hit the wall and you won't be able to feel more comfortable while trying to bring the piece up to speed. So that's usually the main problem. Well, that happens because, you know, the truth is on the first place, your movements and your inner sensations weren't aligned with the music score, then you can't make it fully comfortable by just repeating endless numbers of times. So let's go ahead and see which movements we need in this part to feel comfortable and to avoid any pain that can possibly lead to any injuries. And I already dipped my fingers in the orange juice, and I just want to say that sometimes in this particular part, you would play on the black keys with this part of your finger. I mean, at least I do this. So also I just touch orange with this part. So it's I mean, it helps so much to have good connection to the key and reduce the effort while playing. So your pinky will always make a sound, that's important. So the movements go this way, and okay, little comment. Every time you're gonna play here, if you're not gonna use correct movement of elbow, you will always keep your hand in the stretching position. Like, for example, if you play just all the time like this, which probably you do, that will lead to pain, and that might lead to injuries. So we're going to use elbow movements again to keep our hand to always be in this position. Yes, our hand can stretch, but as soon as you're not going to keep it in a stretching position for all the time, it's fine. So you can stretch and backwards, stretch and backwards. This movement is fine. This movement is not fine. So as you can see in the score, with blue brackets, I already marked the notes that I would take with my left hand. It's clear. Now the basic movement in the right hand goes like this. Left, right, elbow right, right, elbow left. So this pattern is what you need to play comfortably without stretching this, you're stretching your hand. So I'm gonna play right now with imagination, with pedal, and with intonation articulations right away. Just wanna mention that after I mention timbre and dynamics, and remember that dynamics is about the transparency of the picture, when I make voicing, I was imagining first note in this set of three notes closer to myself, so the distance is less to the note that I imagine. So this note is right nearby me. Voicing is really about the distance. The main notes very close to you, less important far away. Dynamics is about transparency of the fiction. Voicing is about the distance. All right. Thank you. twice middle note. And left. And right to my elbow here. Together, D, and over here I'm taking fifth and then sixth. So I'm not doing anything like this or like this. I'm taking fifth and sixth. Now with musical speech, I always keep in mind that I'm going together with my elbow while making good movement with my elbow. I'm intonating octave to the right to prepare my fifth finger so my pinky would never disappear. And when I'm coming down, together again with a feeling of quick elbow movement, I feel that I'm intonating second down to prepare better my finger and also to ensure that the lip is very accurately done, accurately executed. So that's precisely it. And I don't think that I'm thinking even about left hand. So I basically focus only on my right hand, this octaves and second down. So in my mind, it's always like octave set, octave second. So octave second, octave second, octave second, this way. And I engage it, as I said, in my sensations. I connect it with quick elbow movement. So it's very helpful when you are going to speed up. Exception, octave up and fifth down, especially here. I mean, who plays this piece, he knows. Octave and fifth down, and then again come back to octave second. How I'm diminished my interval, so I'm going six, you know, gradually from the octave to the second at the end. I know exactly on which interval I'm coming down. Now is the phrasing, playing by motifs. Starting new motif. again after every phrase, fully exhale, take time. Sentences, and there are two sentences. First has two phrases, second has three phrases. And as you can see, first phrase is going to be more important in the sentence. At the beginning of every sentence, I'm going to slow down just a bit to let my hand fully exhale and kind of have a little bit of rest. And you know, that doesn't sound artificial. I think that naturally goes with the melody. So this is how it goes. I'm gonna pulsate by every quaver. Like this, but in the very beginning of the melody, I'm gonna slow down. So not just down, 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 but go down, 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 down. And in the second sentence, the same. So this is how it goes. So let's start with a moderate tempo. Some difficult fragments to practice. Thank you. elbow backwards, actually. Faster. So let's fix this. And also maybe I should tell myself that I'm not coming back to the second as usually, but to the octave here. And then already to the second. Okay. It's actually kind of an illusion because I'm not doing this. Inside the muscles here, I always, pulsating this way. So I don't have any uncomfortable feelings. So clear. I said it so many times that we can't play fast because we can't feel fast. Not because our fingers cannot move fast or hands can't move fast, but because we cannot really feel the sensation quickly. And in this particular part, the sensation I'm talking about is quickly up with elbow to the octave and quickly down with elbow to the second. So of course, if you can't grasp it in your mind in quick and fast tempo, then you will be just lost. Your fingers will be like playing God knows what. So fingers will be uncontrollable. You can't control your fingers in this case. But as soon as you can imagine it quickly, super quickly in your head, then there's no problems with hands following what you have imagined. So it's all in the head, guys. All right, so on this wise note, I'm gonna end this video. See you in my next one. Bye bye.